Hey guys, last SQL lesson of the day before I head to sleep. So what I have done now is I now have three tables in the database. So if you don't want to create your own tables, then feel free to open up the access file that I've attached to the description of this video. But basically, I have three tables now. The first table is the student table, which you should be familiar with if you have been following my tutorials. I made a subjects table, which is basically a table with three columns or three fields. We got the subject ID, a subject name, and subject teacher. So basically, a table that lists all the subjects of my fake school. So subject ID number one has the name, subject name is English and the teacher is Smith. And subject number two has the name Maths and taught by Chan. So then I've also made an enrollment table that has a list of subject IDs and student IDs so that basically, I can say enroll students in a subject by putting them in this table. So let's say if I want to enroll student number 10 in the subject English, then I can just put subject ID 1, which is English, and student ID 10. And you'll see if you look at the design of this table that both fields are primary keys. And what that means is that you're allowed to repeat just one field. So you can have, for example, you can have two rows with the same subject ID as long as their student ID is different. Okay, so as long as the combination of these two fields are unique, then that's fine. So I can't have another row with 1, 1, for example, because that's already taken up. But I could have 1, 2 or 1, 4, but not 1, 3, because I've already put that there, and so on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm now gonna make a subquery. Okay, so a subquery is basically, let me open up a query. Okay, so a subquery is basically a query within a query. So let's say I select from the students table. Let's just select the student ID, the first name, and the last name from students. Let's just run that. So I got three tables, sorry, three columns of the students table. And what I'm gonna do is I'm only gonna list the students who are enrolled in the subject number one. So I can go, oops, where is my select query? So where the student ID is in, and then I can put another query in here where I select the from the enrollment table where the student ID select student ID. Wait, did I put them in capitals? Student ID from enrollment where the subject ID is equal to one. So, and then I close the bracket. So what I have done is basically I've firstly selected from the enrollment table where the subject ID is equal to one, I've selected all the student IDs. So that's my first query. And it's embedded inside this query where I select all the students from the student table where the student ID is a result from my first query. So if I run this query now, then it's selecting the students 1, 3, 5, 10, which in the enrollment table are the students who were enrolled in the subject ID number 1. So 1, 3, 5, 10. These are the students that were enrolled in that subject. So that's what this query is doing. Subquery is basically just a query. The answer from one query is used to obtain the answer of another query. And now the cool thing is we can actually have a query within a query within a query. So let's say I want to select all the subjects that were taught by the teacher Chan. So I can go select, let's just do it down here. So select, select subject name or subject ID from subjects where subject teacher, is that it? Subject teacher equals Chan. Okay, so then that's obviously going to give me from this little query just here, ignoring everything from up here. If I just look at this query, it's going to give me number 2 as the answer. So instead of saying where subject ID equals something, I can put in here in, and then I can put this inside the bracket. And then I will need to finish it off with 2 brackets, because I have an open bracket here and another open bracket here. So I'm finishing it off with 2 brackets. So this is going to list all the students who were taught by Chan, right? Because I'm firstly selecting the subject ID number 2, which is taught by Chan. And then I'm going to the enrollment table and I'm going to select all the student IDs which are taught by which are enrolled in the subject number 2, so that's 247. And then I go to the student table and I go to the numbers 247 and I list their first name and last name and so on. So let's run that and see if it works. So run it, go to design, run, and yes, it does work. Student 247, which were the ones enrolled in subject number 2. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.